Ben. Remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Radiant Team Ben. Team Liquid's turn to Ben. Radiant Team Ben. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
get a kill here on. He just. Hayaka's coming.
Yeah. This prophet is very hit. Maybe catch up for a walk with a miracle in this mid lane, in terms of net worth at least.
Yeah, they need some clutch. Find a soul.
What?
Pick, but he's gonna Marth it. Marth has some pretty awful turn rate, especially with the sticky.
Yeah.
I think Taiga just stepped away for a brief
moment.
Allowed Wii to.
That's true, and there's no real way to defend yourself without turning right with both abilities, the rebuke and the spear, relying on that. They have pressure on the Wii and punish him. Oh, but it would just about be there. With the body blocks, maybe. There it is. Mikke is going to move through. Fairy Fire won't be good enough. They will find the kill on the Wii.
Yeah, and while it's hard to find these musical lanes, Prophet, you can make this happen. You see, Mikke doesn't really enjoy sitting up top mind control with 11 to 9. They don't really want to put this Prophet constant right.
Yeah, so you can just see, like, Liquid, while they're gonna admit that it's very hard to get the matchups you want in the lanes, at least every time you're forced into these bad matchups, you can find kills on the rotation. And credit to them, they've been doing that pretty damn well. Spear on a GH, but damage might already be done. Roland will also connect, and looks like the Marge should tick down, but nice save comes in from Taiga. Stops Wii from diving, he's gonna try and re-engage, but that toss still available on the Tiny, he can't risk it.
Miracle also, he cleared some stacks. He's almost on par now with Corp. He had that region. And it looks like it's gonna be this magical S. Miracle, maybe we'll see a repeat of that Miracle highlight. Warlock.
Hey, we might. I'm trying to think, like, in this game, It makes a lot of sense, right? Because you're playing against the Mars, and of course the Drow goes for the Gust Chance. Your right flip build might feel a little bit lackluster. Taiga,
look at the Jukuchi there.
Mikke, big trouble. I'm trying to think, like, in this game, it makes a lot of sense, right? It's gonna be the top, the kill on the mind control in the end. They did not get rid of the
away there, thanks to that fairy.
They're keeping the action kicking everywhere, you know, they're around the mid lane as well. They're always kind of hunting, seeing if there's a moment where Quaffer steps
Radiant
up, but also it's back and forth. The movements from Mikke, they did mention on the panel, like, there's limited lockdown available to Nygma to easily punish this Weaver, at least early on.
They have the Earth Spirit, probably also going to Yule's help. It's likely going to be some early mentor BKB.
Oh, nice dodge out! They're gonna get the kill! Beautifully done. Completely dodged out the stun. Now they know Kira has no way of protecting himself. They're gonna move in, look for a secondary kill. Not quite able to force it. Insania will get stuck under the tower. Mikke will go up to make sure they find the kill under the bench first before Insania dies. He's definitely done.
So they're just gonna give it to mind control as well. Getting that 5 kill streak.
It's about time. I mean, Insania, the amount of work he has done in the first 7 minutes of this game is in itself insane.
Miracle. He's gonna, get the portal.
Yeah,
no decision
way.
By Mir. Realizing that. No more stuff.
I mean, well, Pop, he was looking for an opportunity to Boxy. Maybe with the creep wave, he's glyphed this. Roland's could be there. GH on point, but for Boxy. Oh, he hasn't tried to punish Wii. It's just going to go down. The stacks are too much. Avatos, the arena's going to be there. They actually get the kill first. Boxy, still alive, will finally fall. But getting the kill first under Wii there. An unexpected turn in favor of Liquid.
Yeah, he didn't tick down fast enough there. Also, it looks like Okuro almost with this one. And it looks like Miracle is going some sort of hybrid build.
Okay.
Got the treads, but he's still queuing up the Yule.
He'll take the consolation prize of getting his hands on the Tombstone Gold. They're just rotating well as a team. I mean, Liquid, they're getting a little bit of space down here for Boxy. Obviously, they tried to punish him, it backfired a bit. So, when you look at this, you can see that both offlaners in this game are somewhat suffering, but which one is it easier to function as in this game? Yeah, it's going to be easy for Boxy if he finds kills like this.
Yeah, I think for quite a while it's going to be a bit. In terms of net worth, not so much, but it's kind of lagging a bit in the level department. I think this Batrider really needs to get a blink this game. You have the silence from the Raw Ranger. The Weaver is quite elusive and annoying, and there's quite a bit of damage from Liquid's lineup. Batrider. It's hard for him to get on top of targets, and also Taiga is already sitting in there.
Speaking of Taiga, I've been in a little bit of trouble. Nice save there. Miracle's gonna chase in. Rapid Nature through. Almost killing off Miracle. Bug my game on the side. They're able to eliminate it just in time. That would have been a very depressing way to be brought down. While that's happening, well, Boxy, vengeance has been had by Wii. He actually finds a solo pick in return.
Yeah, it's gonna be incredibly beneficial for getting that solo kill. Just the levels, not even so much the gold, of course it helps, but the levels are going to help you quite a lot here. Wanna get this better off levels and just go for the blink probably. Try to be a bit more active.
Zania picked off again in this bot area. I agree with what you said around the bat though, right? Like, you get the XP. Once you have enough levels, you're kind of tanky enough that rushing for a blink doesn't just spell your immediate death, because he's going to need to initiate onto this Drow or this Weaver. He's being initiated on. Boxy says, I don't need a blink dagger. I've got a built-in teammate that provides it.
Taiga is getting close. Didn't go down there, but 1800 gold. 400 away.
I mean, usually if you get a blinking dagger at 14 minutes as a tiny, you're like, that's a pretty decent time for a POS 4, but at this rate, it's going to be, what, 12 and a half minutes? Yeah, it should be 24. Oh, they found the big one. Zygo will try and save him, but the Raffinage is too much damage coming out from Mind Control. Zygo wants to at least punish them here. They'll spear one against the walls, but GH, he's not actually that worried. They're going to turn around, punish Tiger with the rotation from Mind Control. The swap through, they'll find Boxy as well.
Yeah, making the most out of those swaps. Kuro there. Job.
Definitely feels like Liquid, that there is this one weakness that just became very apparent, right? Is the drow. If Liquid do find out at the start of these fights, which they have many means to, you almost immediately have to go on the defensive and try and like cut your losses.
Yeah, it's hard for them to keep fighting. I mean, with the start that Boxy's having, he's not really the standard type of Mars that deals damage core, not the collapse Mars that we've seen a few times where you just kind of go ham, and that means that they don't have a ton of damage anymore if Drow does go down. They've got some spell damage, but it becomes a bit more.
Yeah, Boxy's doing a reverse collapse actually. He's doing the blade mail, so he's more worried about people damage to him than him doing it to them. Tiger's going to have a lot of damage here.
He did
get the blink.
Yeah.
It's not too bad. He got what he needed, and now this is where maybe they can start to get a little bit more active more easily as Liquid. The question is whether we is going to try and match that, because he hasn't committed to the idea of either Boots of Travel or Blink yet.
Yeah, Enigma have done a really good job though. They brought the gold back to pretty much zero. It was kind of going back and forth. Yeah, going just back and forth. But much dead even in terms of net worth. So despite having that really rough initial start with the minus three kills, and they have brought the game.
Definitely, and they've got items upcoming that are going to give them big power spikes, right? GH is getting reasonably close to that Spirit Vessel. At the same time, you know, Miracle could be quick on his way towards the BKB next. And if we does decide to go for this Blink Dagger, Enigma, it's going to be thumbs up. Everyone will be ready to go.
Queued up the Blink now, and I really like I like this draft for Enigma, because it lets them play so fast. Nature's Prophet get some additional scaling with the bench. Same thing goes for Shadow Fiend. They've got these two right clickers that are
all that four. Look who's playing fast is dead. It's actually Liquid, the wraparound, trying to snipe out the spoil. GH able to roll away. But nice move by Liquid to secure this tier 1 tower. I don't think Enigma can defend this now.
I go for the tombstone.
Oh, trying to punish.
Well, he gets it.
Yeah, he gets the Yules.
Yules off.
Now jump in with the last two. On him up. As they've ambushed him, they're dragging him in towards Miracle's main arms, and he'll clean up the kill. The Rapid Nature might scare off more, and Sanya in a bit of trouble. Roll through, will connect from GH. Now he's a tanky boy, but not tanky enough. Tiger looking to get some vengeance here, not able to finish off the kill. The Blink, but he didn't get the urn on him. He's able to toss one away, and he uses it to kill off GH. Tiger showing some flashy plays here. Now, he should be able to get out, as he's got the Blink in 3 seconds. But even if you find him at this stage, the amount of time he'd be wasting his Enigma is just not worthwhile.
Yeah, he doesn't have a port, but like you said, even if you find him, it's too long. Enigma, though, very quick on the smoke.
I like this. It's okay. That you shot your luck. It's our turn to point all barrels towards that drow and let loose, as they'll easily pick off quick fight.
Yeah, and I was saying, I really like this lineup for Enigma. They can play really quickly with lineup. They have worked. They got the scaling in the Nature's Prophet and NSF, and normally these heroes just, if you don't have the Venge, they don't scale as well. But together with that Venge, gives you some additional scaling. All these heroes are very high tempo. They can play them all really well for Enigma.
Hello, Captain. Gonna be brought down. They're bringing multiple heroes here to deal with them. I like you bring that up. I think it's also a case of like how easy is it for Enigma to, as any one of their heroes, just find a cheap pickoff, right? Like, you can see that Liquid, they kind of have this pretty cool, strong team fight around the arena, whereas Enigma seems a lot stronger when it comes to just quick gank rotations.
Yeah, exactly. Enigma just want to play the map, just play as fast as they can, and Liquid, they want to slow down the game a little bit, make sure that the draw gets to get some farm. You want to get maybe the pike, maybe the things that let you not die. that rider again.
It's the ease of saving as well, right? Like this drow is going to be a vulnerability for Enigma for Liquid Rather for quite a while, because their save isn't the easiest, right? It's a bit complicated. You could save with Tiny, you could put a good arena down that saves him, but then you compare it to Enigma. Like, if Miracle's ever in trouble, they've got GH and Kuro that have ways of helping him out and getting him out.
Yeah, I think it's about the pick.
Oh, and a Batrider pick is going to look even smart as they find the big one. Quickfa in a lot of trouble. There's the heal out from Insania, not good enough. They're going to bring him down. Insania, he actually mans up and looks to fight. Mika has arrived. Mind Control's going to stand his ground, but now he realizes he needs to get out. Nice swap, but there's still the arena. They're going to skew one. Kuro being brought low as well. Volsi's going to stand his ground. Tiger, the sooner the GH to keep him away, they're going to turn it into a triple kill for Mika. They say, you silly fools. Quickfoot was the bait all along. This bug is our carry. We might find even more.
He'll be able to get out.
Miracle is here. Look at Miracle. And he's got the right pick. Yep, yours. See Tiny. Queen Bomb. Be able to find the pick onto the Tiny. And Mika, he'll at least get GH for his troubles. Miracle, not really able to fight much more. Needs to actually now run. Mika might just try and hunt him down here. Decides against it, though, is, you know, those tier 2 towers, they do pack quite the heavy punch. And Mind Control is back up again. Now looking for Insania. The Yules, the time to set up the Sprout, set up everything they need to kill off the Undying.
That Yules, he has some nice catching tools. They have more than enough damage to hit him, even without the
Right now, this game has just turned into a race between Mika and Miracle to see who can kill the other's team quicker right now. And
this DD might not be quite a...
It might, and he's actually getting close. I think he's got recipe coming out. Yeah, he's almost got the Manta complete. As I talk about that, Boxy in the bot lane does get picked off. There's a ping coming out, moving in. Tiger on point, spotting out Mind Control, will find Vengeance. And Tiger very quickly trying to find a way to replace Boxy as the posture in this game. His fair share of kills.
Yeah, Boxy having a pretty rough game. I mean, the Batrider pick, the first four heroes of Liquid, you know, bar the Weaver, they are extremely... They all suffer quite heavily versus Sticky. Some abysmal turn rates. The fights can become quite difficult.
Yeah, it's kind of right now, it feels like it's a matchup between Tiger and Wii, right? Like, who can find the jump first? Who can find the critical target? And then who can force the other to react? That's how you maybe leverage the advantage. But it's going to require Boxy getting some farm, getting to a point where you can do the same. Miracle looking to punish Tiger jumping, rolling, actually connects onto a bigger target, but Mika not held in place for long enough. No, Miracle chases into the BKB, but it's not going to be good enough. Lasso's too late, they'll at least get the kill on the Weaver. But that's your BKB, Miracle being brought down. They're going to lose more on their side as Kuro falls, the arena goes down, Wiki's been found as well as a triple kill for Quakefa. I'm seeing a pattern here. Whenever Liquid lose the POS 1 or the POS 2, the other one gets 3 or 4 kills.
Yeah, and excellent trade there. Miracle held the DKB just a little bit too long. Took a bit too much damage. Couldn't get the Requiem off. The Death Requiem kinda is what killed the Weaver in the end, but still, you get the SF kill on the draw, and you could potentially bar Roche. They're gonna just shoot Tower the glyph instead, and Quakefa, he skipped. Now the pike just goes for this faster BKB instead. This is when the physical damage, gotta wonder if it's gonna be enough at this point.
Well, another good side to that for Liquid, right, is that Boxy lives. Boxy, he's been needing a bit more XP, a little bit more gold. He's starting to get towards that blink. And if this is the counter initiation and their initiation strength in its current form, imagine what it gets like when Mars has a blink online as well.
Yeah, it's not going to get easier.
So I think maybe for them, the big thing, yeah, I thought so. Mind Control, he's going towards the BKB next. They just need to get match community on multiple people here. I wouldn't be surprised if we consider some of that. He's going for 4 staff instead, though. I guess in his mind, like, he doesn't need to be the frontliner, he just needs to make sure that his counter initiation is quick enough and strong enough to protect Miracle.
Yeah, I would actually really like to see... I mean, the 4 staff is not bad. I would like to see a BKB high. I feel like that would make the fight difficult. I mean, if we can get to the point where he has some sort of BKB Shiva, I think then the game can become quite difficult for Liquid. Because if the battle order is too hard to right away, it's gonna cause so much chaos in the fight that it's gonna be hard to find these other targets. But he's gonna go for the four star first, you know, kind of depending on what sort of game he has, and then start to think of further scaling. But for now, settling for the four star.
Seeing if it helps or hinders him. He's gonna find some progress towards that iron box. He is gonna be picked off. Science stops, so no chance to even try for a counter arena. Just wanna get in that shape. You can tell Tiger. Buyback out from Boxy. GH with the roll is gonna connect on the Tiger. Koifa decided to sidestep it, but Mike is gonna be there to clean up, or is he? The roll through GH, beautifully done. He creates the space for himself to move away. And now they got a big buyback out of Liquid. But now,
you can tell GH has a lot of experience. First pretty very quick on the buttons there.
Arena's gonna go down, they do lose it, but they'll find Kuro in response. Buyback comes out from the Undying with the arena down. Nigma have no interest in flying, especially with that tombstone still there. Which means they'll have to surrender this over. Liquid will get their hands on the Roshan. Aegis in the hands of Mike, moving forward, looking for more now with that DD still run. An avalanche from Tiger. Science, they can't get the top ball up. The control will have to be turned instead on the GH as they move in and pursue him. Mike's under the tower, looking for the kill, will be able to find it. And while they're here, they'll take the tier 1 as well. While that's happening, you will actually see Tiger go down because the magnetize was a little bit too much for him.
Yeah, the Vessel, the magnetize, and all the damage from the Batrider, it was just enough to get the kill on the Tiny. So in the end, I think you're going to be pretty happy with that. We do have the Aegis on this Weaver, who's already quite hard to deal with, going for the Lincolns. It's going to be very hard to find an answer to this Weaver, especially with the Aegis, Lincoln, Manta, etc.
On mid lane, Lasu, Undone dying. I mean, that's going to be his dieback, so a nice kill. Gets him the prime 69 death timer.
And just go for it more team fight-ish, helping your team out with the Lotus. Some way of dealing with the Lasso.
Yeah, you need someone to protect these big cores, right? Like, but right now, the X factor really can be in this type of game, so you need to find a way to counter that out. Tiger, found a big one. Swamp's gonna come into him though. You got sized up by GH. Kuro in a bit of trouble in the river. The arena will go down and make sure that Miracle cannot find a target while they clean up their own.
Yeah, I'm really a little bit curious to see what Miracle goes for here. It's most likely going to be some notes. It's just question is which item is equal. Manta, Sky, Butterfly, MKB. Get some sort of damage.
Oh, moving in. Ava, Toss, is there on a Miracle? Zone on that BKB is going to use that. Last few dragons going to be there, and the bomb gets the two. Both the kill on Tiny and on a Mars. GH able to move away just in time. They did use the BKB on Quakefur as well, so an uncomfortable situation for Liquid, to say the least.
I think you're very happy with how that went. Get that lasso, you pull him in Requiem, get out without losing anyone. Even GH managed to get out. The silence hits as the roll is already, you know, being committed. They're gonna pick up a lot of binding runes here. Mind control just got to get out.
Yeah, it's not of your life for maybe a kill onto a POS 5 at this stage. You don't know where the other heroes are. I mean, that's a wise choice because Quaker was on his way. But actually, look at the situation with the map. Like, you think about the vision game, you can see that Liquid had these intentions around the tier 2s to try and push in these towers. But now Nigma are able, with their vision and with these kills, to split up and take like 2/3 of the map under their wings.
Yeah, you can see Mind Control, he's just constantly working his way towards this AC, want to further their sort of team fighting. I like that Kuro also just going for this Crimson Guard. They're really committing to these sort of. I mean, it's nice to see they have the Venge Aura. They're gonna have the AC on Mind Control. They're gonna have this Avenge Crimson on Kuro.
Radiant's
all their heroes are scaling.
Or Enigma. Meanwhile, Miracle is continuing down that more magical side of things. He's going for a little bit of lockdown there. So it doesn't feel like he needs to increase his physical DPS.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Yeah, interesting. They do have this already, the Koikva, so magical damage. But yeah, Miracle is committing to the so magical build here, I think. Going for the Hex into
full in. He says, Mike Troll, you handle the physical. I'm getting amped up by you plus the vent. That'd be good enough. Mike, they're up round. Sees Miracle. Lincoln's already been popped. Miracle struggling to run away from this. The spear will connect onto it. Just enough of a touch is that it cancels the TP and sets up a nice clean kill onto the true POS 1 of the side of it.
Pretty big kill. They're so close to the... Got creep. They got a creep.
And they've got a read-up, so they can count this play. This is ambitious from Woodfu. Woodfu will get the BKB out. He'll turn around and find Skura in the arena as well. They'll find one, they'll find two, but no three. The other ones get out, but the problem is your tower, it's going to be fallen, and that was perfectly timed by Liquid as the Aegis just expired.
Yeah, and it's very hard to actually draw down another right outside the base with a draw lineup.
No, they're in the base.
Tiger too.
Yep. They go straight in. Tiger just relentless in his search for more blood. And they'll find as GH's head gets claimed before Hero is dead. This is going to be at least a tier 3 tower. In fact, look what they have the damage to easily take the racks as well.
It's a very, very... You have a draw lineup. You kill these buildings. Start with that. You're dealing a lot of damage in these fights going... I mean, he had the BKB, he just didn't want to use port out there.
But now Mick,
it comes back to bite him a bit.
Ooh-wee. He'll blink. He's able to move away quick enough. Tiger's still being burned up by the flame break, but he has got the Yules there. The toss fall-off's going to be good, and the Avalanche is coming off cooldown as well. Can he get away? It's going to be... It looks like he just about gets out of range. BKB, but he's hunting forward. The following two hits will come in. Nice save for the moment with a wand. But the zombies are doing too much work. He's dead. You can understand why he's there, right? Like, Nygma are trying to get control of these lanes because they don't want to risk so quickly losing a second set of racks, but Liquid's so quick to punish it.
Yeah, he wants to be out on the map to make it happen, but... Many heroes here. Still have mind control. Healing, he's gonna finish this now. Getting a little bit difficult for them with just how strong Mickey is.
Yeah, it feels like it takes so long to kill any of these heroes as well, right? Like, with the way they're kind of bulking up, even the Undying, actually. Like, look how much health Insania has available to him with the Blade Mail as well. You kind of see him, and usually at this stage you think, Undying is a quick kill, we'll get rid of him, we'll move on to the next. But even he is wasting a few crucial seconds of Nygma's time that can allow Liquid to turn the fight.
Yeah, and just how much damage it would now have with the operational...
It's behind Drow. She's close to where this lasso's happening. They're going to drag Tiger. They want to punish the initiator, but the Yules is going to get rid of all the damage. They need Miracle's assistance because they're all in. Koifa's going to poke and prod, but he cannot save Tiger's life. He actually needs to get out of it quick, in fact. Don't want to risk invoking the wrath of Nygma here, not when you're outnumbered.
Yeah, but the... Oh, no.
You gotta be kidding me.
The runes have been helping out quite a bit. But the cool thing about Liquid's lineup now is that they've got these three beefy boys dying the both Koikva and Mikia just deal a lot of damage.
Then this choice to go multi blade mails, right? It especially hurts someone like we in this game who he's going for the BKB now. But because he stopped off that 4-star, of course, it means he's actually, in these fights, at risk of just kind of assisting his enemy in killing himself.
Yeah, just tanking up, going for blade mills. Making it harder for targets.
Role-playing the hedgehog, please don't hurt me. You know, you just press the blade mail, it's like, oh, okay, I guess he looks cute, I'll let him live for a few seconds. Those extra few seconds, and off a Liquid time and time again. They will waste no seconds going into this smoke. Mikkei's smoke will break on Kuro. He's found the back line. Open it up, this kill is actually a good one. That means there'll be no swap save. They do pop the link, it's going to be a drag away, but we, he's not able to do anything. He's just doing this to try and save Venge's life, and that won't even work. He will die with his captain.
Mind control immediate top, trying to apply at least some bit of pressure up top here, because
a mid. Oh, they found the big one. Miracle, he didn't use the BKB. He can't use the BKB, he's gone. Oh, no. 75 seconds dead. Roach is going to be up in 20 seconds if Liquid even go for that, because they're probably thinking your base looks mighty tasty about now.
I mean, they saw that he just picked up the site. They should consider this. Miracle has no buyback, I think.
They're going to get both. Look at Mika. Yeah, look at Mika as well. He's setting it up so they can get Megan. There's actually nothing you can do here. You can see Mind Control's trying to cut through the wave, but they've already got creeps on the high ground.
Mind Control put his most valiant efforts into at least getting something in exchange. He's able to take that tier 3 tower, but it's gonna be very minimal in comparison.
They'll be keeping TP away, barely. Now, can they punish this now that Foxy's not here is the real question. BK, he's got that Lipkins. We have to back away. They're going for the Megas. Quizper has the BKB in time. GH in a little bit too deep. He's going to be turned around upon. Tiger just standing his ground. It's too tanky to get through easily. Chase by more time with the Ghost Scepter. Swap to get him out. Kuro in trouble. Will be brought down. The Tiny. It's not enough to burn him out at the end, though. He barely lives on 10 HP. The reinitiation from Mika. They're going to pop the link. The turnaround. The last two is good enough. They bring him down. He's dead. Buyback out from the bench. Can they find more with this? Quickfa. Glimmer caved up to the high ground. Foxy has arrived. Arena jumping. No, the toss. The spin. They put GH out of the arena. He's gonna live because of a Tiger now in trouble. He's gonna be hexed up, chased onto. There's a heal on Piggy. Time to go to slaughter. They'll turn for Foxy as well. GH, min max his life pool, making sure that Liquid feel mighty bad about saving his life.
And I mean, they could have just given up this bottom lane and maybe just gotten the Mega Creeps with the Mars, but the kinda does bite them. Now they're gonna have to commit some buybacks. They did use the buyback on Kuro.
They did.
Not gonna have that for this upcoming Roach fight, but you don't have Mika.
Nope.
You wanna defend this Roach, you might have to buyback on your Weaver. That's a pretty heavy committal.
They're gonna buyback on the Mars first. See if that deters. They're TPing in now. There's an arena in 10 seconds, and I don't think we're equipping enough. They need a kill. Zone away the illusions. Doesn't want to reveal their hand too quickly. We moving up to the high ground, Foxy. He's gonna break on him. He has got the arena. It connects on the two. Kuro's caught in it. That's gonna be his buyback situation. Buyback for the Weaver, trying to get in the record on the back line. Quickfa in trouble. He's gonna be brought down. He will now buy back. They'll finally find a kill to Kuro. Avalanche told to try and kill Wee. He's barely alive. Able to move away, but he can't get across. It's not gonna work. He had no way of getting down to the low ground in time. They'll just tap him down with the spear. The buyback will come out now, out from the Fireflying Batrider and the Insania Undying, but I don't know what you do this now, Enigma. I don't think you can do anything.
Yeah, I think with the dieback there on Kuro, you can't take this fight 45. You did bring this 8k Gold Leap back down to pretty much even, but you're gonna give away the cheap here. You did buyback on both of you.
That's so the concern.
No buyback on the Weaver or the Draw Ranger, but you have Aegis on Koikla. Got the butterfly, it's got the BKB.
I mean, I guess the surprising part, like the part that kind of baffled me was the Wii buyback at the end. Like, was there, do you think they were considering going back in there? Because it seems like
they wanted to continue that fight. Mind control?
Hello. The true carry has arrived. Toss back on a Wii. That's the liability of what he done. He's dead. That's his buyback. And they're five! They're ready to go! They've got the arena again! Mind Control is gonna have to pull a miracle out of his own ass here! I don't know how he's gonna do it! Rolling for GH, causing the anarchy here. Set the fights in some time against the physical anger. Arena's gonna go down there, pin against the wall. This Lara is coming through, they're gonna find the kill with the Kura and GH. Buyback will come out from the ladder. But now what do you do? It's free! I mean, it's Mega Creeps, Liquid. I don't think they're going to wait around, not with this big liability of we having no buyback, being dead for 60 seconds. Liquid want to end it. They're going to move in.
Somehow you got to hold this 5 versus 8. We have a Rapier on Mind Control, but no buyback. Miracle, no buyback. No buyback.
There's no buybacks anywhere right now. This is going to be tense. They know that if they're going to do something, it has to be
Control, toss on the spot. GH is in trouble, and Mind Control, this rapier doing absolutely nothing. Mike says, yoink!